video. You can build this online CV that's not a piece of paper, and it can, you know, it will, you know, kind of package it nicely. So along with your resume and along with your, you know, paper CV, you can submit this, you know, wonderful visual of videos you've done. Maybe you've produced some videos and directed some videos, or, you know, nice photography. Anything that you're doing online, even like your social networks and your blog, but it makes it really, really nice. And it has, have any of you heard of Guy Kawasaki? Guy Kawasaki? Okay. He's like a huge pioneer in like online job hunting. I would definitely write his name down. He does
alltop.com, A-L-L-T-O-P.
Yeah, he's really great. I would definitely, like, you know, research some of the books. He's one of our required readings, definitely at Schiffel. I have heard him talk a few times, and he has a lot of great things to say, so I definitely, if you have a pin, like Guy Kawasaki, yeah. But he stands behind this platform. I hope he'll put his name behind it. My Workster, this is really great for you guys. This is specifically for college students to reconnect with their alumni. You already have something in common, that's your college. So there's already that, you know, interline thread where they want to help you. They want to see other alumni do well in the business and in the corporate world. So, you know, here you can connect with your alumni. JobFox, it's like an online dating site for, not literally dating, but it takes, you know, your interest, and it also takes the employer's interest and matches you up. And says, you know, I swear.
We were talking about this before. How it's like, like first you're nervous and you have to try to impress them.
It is like dating.
See if you like each other.
Send them a photo. But I actually kind of just want to, I like my job, I don't want to leave it, but I just want to test it out. I really do. Because it just, you fill out, I guess, a profile, and the employer fills out a profile. Here's the link right here.
Well, it's the same thing if you think about it.
Yeah.
You have to deal with those people every single day.
Yeah, right. And you definitely need to fit with the culture. So I think this is a great one, actually. I really do. I love it. That's pretty cool. I mean, I guess this is what me and Caitlin are the most passionate about here. Not only our personal brands, but making sure you do become a face. And you're taking these online relationships offline, and that's, you know, a huge advocate of thank you cards. You know, writing a thank you card. My dad, he's in HR, and he, first of all, my dad told me to get off Facebook after I graduated. Third of all, he said, you write a thank you note, and you take it up to the company, and you hand deliver that thank you note. Yeah, it might be 30 minutes out of your way, but you know, you're gonna be remembered. And you know, if you're found on, you know, a social network, that extra step of writing that hand thank you note is going to go so much further, and they're going to see your face again. This is our CEO, and we were so close. So make personal
he brought
contact.
Pizza, so we were hugging him. This is happening in the picture.
So make personal contact, maybe not on this extreme level, but make personal contact. I was telling you, we had a huge discussion about this before we came here. Before I started working at Schiffel, I saw on Maggie, who was the girl I knew at Schiffel, that she was going to Via Colori. It's where you draw on the sidewalk downtown, and it's a really nice art show. And I saw she was going. And I knew from Schiffel's culture that there would be some Schiffel people there, and I love art anyway, so I went, and I ran into her, and I ran into some other Schiffelites. So I not only got in front of managers, I got in front of just some employees who knew who I was and hopefully got my name out there. But she swears up and down it was stalking. I do not think this I was persistent.
So lots of companies will post events on Facebook and on Flickr, and that's kind of the first place that they'll post. Also, something to think about is, like, we do our big Schiffel conference every year, and most conferences have a student rate, and they'll post those, and so that's something, like, our conference was, it was like $20 for students or something really inexpensive.
And it was at the zoo, so.
Yeah, and they'll post, like, specials or, you know, deals or kind of tweet-ups or things like that where you can get more of an intimate, you know, meet people in person, because it's a lot of it, like Courtney said, is it's not just a magic pill that you can be online, like sitting in your basement by yourself and like get a job. You have to take that gets your foot in the door, and then you sort of take the next step to leave the house, go meet people,
just take that shake their hand
out the door.
Exactly.
So here's our homework. Fun time. The first thing that I think that you should do, if you haven't, you probably have before, because I do it all the time, maybe I'm just here, is Google yourself and figure out, you know, just see what comes up first, what doesn't come up that should, what is, you know, your Zanga from 6 years ago that you forgot about, is that coming up first? Or and one thing I will say is that Google loves social media. If my Twitter account comes up first a lot of times when I Google myself over anything else, just because Google, I don't know, they love Twitter and Facebook and all those things. So see what's on there, see what's missing, see what's, you know, maybe you should think about taking down or reworking, or, you know.
Can I add something?
Yeah.
With a lot of our clients, we see you want to have control of that entire first page when someone Googles your name. You want every single link to go to you personally, to go to some content that you put out there, valuable content, not some old college photo. But some really valuable content. You really want to be, because a lot of times people don't go past that first page. So if you have the upper hand when someone searches your name. So make sure, like Caitlin said, make sure that, you know, when you Google yourself, that they're
and
actually
some of us
finding
have,
you.
My last name is Czech, and so not a lot of people have it, so I'm kind of lucky. But, you know, we've had clients who, you know, are named Amanda Jones and have a really hard time getting on the first page. So you may have to work a little bit harder. Have people misspell our names our whole life, so it's not a problem. But the next one is grab your name on social networks. Even if you say, I don't think I want to use Twitter, but just in case I decide later that I might, go ahead and grab your name, because a lot of people who are getting in now are saying, oh, you know, I really want to be this name and I just can't get it. And it's happening with companies too, where there was like ExxonMobil, somebody grabbed their name, and there was I think Chevy, it happened too, and the guy, like, his last name was Chevy or something, so they couldn't do anything about it. And so, you know, your name is your personal brand. And like me, I'm Caitlin Kalugia, or I'm QKate. So I am anywhere QKate, QKate.com, Twitter QKate, Facebook QKate, like everything. So it doesn't necessarily have to be like first name, last name, but yeah, grab your name on Facebook, Twitter, anything that you might think you might want to use, just so someone else can.
Even a domain.
Yeah, the domain.
I have a domain.
One of our guys at work just got engaged, and he said the first thing he did was grab their like brookanddereck.com domain so that they would have it, and yeah, so it's important. The third one is commit to a few and establish a hub. So, you know, we've talked about some, and there are definitely more. We didn't even talk about Vimeo or YouTube or Flickr or any of those sort of artistic outlets. What I found is start small, start with a couple of things. Maybe you're on Twitter, but you're not really, don't really know how to use it, and sort of, or you're on LinkedIn, but you really need to beef up your profile. Start with something, and then you can kind of grow one at a time. And then as far as establish a hub, for me, it's my blog. There's one place you can go to and see all my links. For some people, it's they want their Facebook page, and they have all their links on the side. For some people, it's, you know, it can be anything, but kind of figure out where you want your main home base to be.
Also, another thing that, you know, I really think that y'all should take home with you today is keep providing passionate content. Don't write for what you think an employer wants to see. Write what you want to write. And someone is going to appreciate that, and the person that appreciates it is going to be someone you want to work for. You don't want to work for someone that you can't be yourself. And so, if it is just something crazy, I mean,
I write about random things.
Yeah.
One of my pictures was, people think I look like Flo from the Progressive Insurance commercials.
She does.
And so I did a blog post where I like dressed up like Flo and I tried to do my hair like her, and I did a side-by-side. Yeah. It's like the most crappy post on my blog.
And that makes you, you know, who you are.
Yeah, and it's
just, and now it's like Flo. We love you.
So, it doesn't have to be 100% related to what you're
right. Exactly.
That's too, but Flo's like in Tennessee or something. I forgot where she lives at.
And when you see her out of makeup, she doesn't look the same. She looks really different. So,
that's okay. Neither does Paula Deen. I don't want to go there.